something. I'm here with my friend Sarah today. She also has a website. It's Ren Makeup at Tumblr. I'll put the link down below so you guys can check out her makeup. We're gonna be doing our July favorites today. So we each have five things that we both use in the month of July that we're gonna be showing you today. We haven't shown each other or talked to each other about what we're showing today. So it's gonna be kind of, what you're seeing is gonna be
a surprise. We have different skin, we have different hair, so we're showing each other.
Even though we kind of look like sisters. We could be sisters.
We might be.
The Chanel Illusion d'Ombre eyeshadows. I got these about last year, I think it was. But I've been using them a lot this month because, you know, like I'll come across them in my makeup drawer and I just have to use them because they're like the most beautiful. I mean, it's not going to translate on camera, but
is it next a cream?
Time, it's like a cream shadow, but it's like mousse.
Okay,
mousse-like.
Yeah.
But next time you're at like a Chanel counter or something, please check these out, swatch them.
Yeah, swatch them on your hand.
You have to, this one is called Fantasme, number 81. It's like a white shimmery, it looks exactly like snow. At night, like when it's like fresh snow on the ground and you just see the sparkles, like that's exactly what it looks like. This one is Epatant number 84. I can't really pronounce these names, but it's like a green, like what would you, kind of like a mossy green?
Yeah, it kind of reminds me of Green Smoke eyeshadow
from MAC.
So I know that this is pretty boring, but I'm going to go with a brow pencil. It is important, and I usually use a powder. I'm not really big on pencils. I know that you really like the Anastasia pencils.
Yeah. Well, I always did the powders, and then I was like, I kind of like, for on the go.
I find that the Anastasia ones are a little too creamy, and this one is more of like a dried pencil. It has a comb on the back, just like a regular. The color I use is Natural Brunette. It comes in Natural Brunette. And it's kind of like a reddish brown, but I just find it's a really nice pencil. It's one that I grab, and I never use pencil. The only downside to it is it doesn't come with a cap.
Yeah, it's just say, like that. It just like twists back into the thing.
Yeah, I lost the cap for the bottom.
Okay.
But so it doesn't come with a cap.
Oh, that's nice. It's very...
But you know what I mean? It's not as creamy as the Anastasia.
It's not as creamy, but it's like... And it's not moving at all on my hand.
So,
That's nice. It's a good brow pencil.
That's my brow pencil. Trish McAvoy.
Never use that.
Natural Brunette.
And that's Impassioned by MAC. It's a MAC lipstick. And it's an amplified...
Amplified cream. Right?
Amplified. Okay, so this is, it's like, how would you even describe it? It's like a neon corally pink.
It's like fruit punch acid.
Yes. More like
bonkers.
Fruit punch. It's not fuchsia. It's not light pink. It's like a very, very unique color. You cannot obviously see it on my lips, but I got this a little while ago, but I've just been, it's like one of those things that I've been like falling asleep, like thinking about it, like I need to wear it tomorrow. So I wore it like a lot this month.
Next, I have a lipstick from Laura Mercier, and the color is called Mistress. And I found out about this color because I read on an AMC.com blog about the show Mad Men that the makeup artist uses this color for the character of Joan, which is played by Christina Hendricks.
A little sex pot.
And it's an awesome kind of, it's kind of like
coral.
Like your colors, like,
but like
grown up sister.
Yeah,
sort
yeah.
of. Like, it's just a really great coral, but it's toned down, but it's still really vibrant. Awesome for redheads, awesome for fair skin.
This is by China Glaze, and it's called Flip Flop Fantasy. And it is like a neon, like I'm not even kidding, it glows in the dark. And I don't even know if it's supposed to, it's just so neon, it glows in the dark. I've been wearing this on my toes pretty much all of July, and I can't stop staring at it. I wear sandals a lot more when I have this on because I love staring at it and I get tons of compliments, whatever.
My next thing is NARS eyeshadow base. This is really boring. It's their Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. I've had this for six... I guess it came out within the past year.
Okay.
I've had this for like 6 months and I still have stuff in it. It looks a little gross. But it has like a lip gloss applicator doe foot wand. I get oily eyelids. All my shadows crease. I have to wear a shadow base, and this is the only one that I can wear all summer that just like holds up no matter how hot or sweaty or anything I am. So I wear this even sometimes if I'm not wearing eyeshadow just to cancel out the redness on my on my lids. So
my next product is a body product. It's by Bodycology. It's a toasted vanilla sugar body scrub. And it's very inexpensive. It's like $5.99. It's brand new. I think they just revamped their line and they got rid of some stuff and they got some new products. And I know that they got a few new scents and discontinued some old scents. And I really love this because, for one, the packaging, it's so much easier to use in the shower than like a jar that you have to like unscrew and then you don't know what to do with the lid, or like water's getting in there.
That it just is. I don't know why they don't make jars with like a flip cap.
Yeah,
but this is genius.
Yeah, so there's not a lot of product, but again, it's $5.99, and what I love so much about it is that you can't really see it, but there's like, it's packed with like large granules of sugar. So it's like, sometimes they're like too oily. Ooh, and there's not that much scrub. This has a lot of scrub. It
smells yummy.
And it smells so good.
My next product is the Original Mineral K Gravel Texture Clay. And this is the travel size. It comes bigger.
Is that the brand, Original Mineral?
Original Mineral is the brand. O&M, it's called. It's like a hair color. They're known for their hair color, but it comes in a bigger size. I carry this one because it's just easier. It has here, check this out. Because it's a pomade, just like a regular pomade, but here, feel that. It's really weird. It has pumice stones in it, so it's like gritty in your hair, so and it makes it like a little.
Just kidding.
It makes it like a little like dirty feeling, and it's matte as opposed to like a really shiny pomade.
Smells
for me,
too.
Shiny pomades make my hair feel dirty and like look dirty. So I just like prefer that. Yeah, I have it in there now.
As you can see, Sarah has awesome short hair. This is coming off from a shaved head.
Men, good for men too.
Great
right?
for men. I think that's who it was originally for.
It
being
so
matte
good, like, beachy.
No, but like vanilla beachy.
Yeah. Okay, this is my last product. I only have the sample sizes because I was just kind of trying it out. But I'm definitely going to purchase the large size. It is called Reversa Antioxidant Booster Serum. So it's an antioxidant serum, obviously, but what it does is it keeps kind of like the environmental damages, like UV rays, or, you know, it's kind of like an anti-aging product, would you say?
It's like a serum?
It's a serum. Like, how would you describe like antioxidants?
Antioxidant to me seems like it's probably helping with those UVB, UVA rays, pollution.
Yeah, it kind of just creates a barrier on your skin to keep it, you know, protected and stuff. And
it smells kind of cool.
It smells good. Try it. And it's not an oily
serum. It
smells
like green apple or something.
It's like lemony, though,
creamy.
Too. Yeah, it's a creamy serum. So that's what's amazing about it. It's not an oily serum because I kind of have oily combination skin. It's hydrating. It's not greasy whatsoever. Like, once I put this on about 2 minutes, I'll put my makeup on. Like, it's
my
great.
Final product is the Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer from NARS. It's their newest foundation or skincare with coverage in it. Joanna and I were talking a little bit about Laura Mercier. She's a big fan of the Laura Mercier foundations and tinted moisturizers. I'm not. I find that they oxidize just a little too dark on me. I don't think they have enough coverage in them, but again, it's a tinted moisturizer, so it's not supposed to have coverage, but I like a little bit more coverage. It comes in a shade called Finland, which is light number one.
Is it the lightest shade?
It's the lightest, of course,
okay.
Yeah. It's the lightest shade that they make. It's perfect. It's perfect for me. It has an SPF of 30 in it, PA++, which I guess is like super sunscreen.
And
you know what I mean? Like,
moisturizer?
It's more, yeah, like there's more pigment to it.
Smells good.
I think
maybe
it
that's
smells.
The serum.
No, I think it does. It smells better than the La Mercier.
Oh, that's nice. It does have a little bit more.
I'm just
coverage.
Not really a fan of the La Mercier skin products. Or
does
really
it?
The brand, I don't think. I don't really like it. I mean, other than that lipstick, it's just not.
I love
it's not my bag.
We just tried these OPI nail stickers. Like, what are they called?
They're called OPI Pure Lacquer Nail Apps.
Okay.
OPI is getting into like the design game all of a sudden because they've never.
Well, everybody's doing like the nail decals and stuff, so I guess OPI is like jumping on the bandwagon.
So Joanna has on the. Do they not have a style name? What? They don't have a name of
pink
the
style. And black lace.
Okay,
it's at the bottom. So these are. I don't know if you can see. Pink and black lace, really pretty. Sarah has on.
I don't know the name of it.
But it's this. It's.
It's kind of like a metallic flower type of thing. And then it comes in reptile, which is really cute, and metallic waves, which is like a zebra with glitter. The only downside to this, I think, between this and the Sally Hansen,
there's some left over and you can't save them.
Yeah, like, the Sally Hansen's like airtight packaging, so they don't dry
out.
But
they do. They do have a shelf life. I've tried to put them on after opening them, and they're like sliding off.
Yeah.
But I think that these won't last quite as long.
Exactly.
Because they don't have the little box you can put them back in. See, like, I tried to do it months later. I feel like these do have just a day or so.
Exactly. I'll hang on to them, though. Maybe, you never know, maybe they do work differently than that. But everything about it is telling me that it's probably the exact same thing.
Yeah. So packaging, not so good. But quality, like, I put these on right before we started filming.
Yeah.
Like, it took me 5 minutes.
Well,
thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed everything on all our July favorites. Stay tuned for more videos with our special guest Sarah. Let her know how much you loved her and her pink hair and want her back soon, okay? Renstaroni. No, wait.